Hi, I'm Shaoyi. I come from China. Today, I'm going to take you on the campus tour of Mawson Lakes. And by the end, I hope you will know the campus a little bit better. I completed my Bachelor of Degree of Engineering at UniSA, and now I'm studying a Master of Engineering with focus on the electrical power. Let me show you around. The Mawson Lake campus is close to Technology Park and the Defense Precinct. We have many industry connections with these companies like Flight Training Airlab. A lot of students want to know about getting to campus, as Mawson Lake is about like 25 minutes drive from the city center. And you can get the trains here, as the station is only 5 to 10 minutes walk from the campus. There are also a bus stop close by there and plenty of car parks. It costs less than $2 Australian for the whole day of parking, and the fare of the trains and buses is about $1 Australian and $2-3 Australian, which is less than a cup of coffee. Let's go in the materials and manual size building, also we call it MM building. This campus is where the STEM programs are taught, so that includes anyone studying science, technology, engineering, and math degree. The building is designed so you can see that into the world of scientists, which is why this library has been designed with the glass walls. There is a big focus on the research and science in this area. This lab belongs to the Future Industrial Institute, who conduct the research and relates to the needs of the industry. Over this side, you can see the study and printing station area. You will find this in a few places around the campus. I will now show you one of our many lecture theaters on campus. This is used for teaching, student teaching, and research events. Actually, I have lots of memories here. I attended my first class here, which was the Java courses. Let me turn the camera and show around. Lecture theaters are where the students will learn their weekly content before attending the tutorial, practical, or laboratory sessions. Sometimes there are also industry events held in here. Let's go back out and go to the next area. We're now walking through the one of the cafes area on campus. They have fresh juice and good breakfast and some lunch options. That was very quick walkthrough of what you can find on the ground floor of MM buildings. As I mentioned, I'm studying the Master of Engineering with focus on the electrical power. And actually, UniSA has a lot of different engineering specializations for undergraduate and postgraduate degree. For example, like electrical engineering, mechanical engineering, civil engineering, management engineering, and heaps more. Something beneficial for the study in engineering or construction management degree is professional practice program. This professional practice program is start as your first year and adds up to 450 hours to about the professional experience. And it could be involved like in placement, internship, site view, and night working opportunities. This all depends on your degrees. And for example, like me, my internship was at the power distribution station. Actually, I learned a lot of during this internship, and like industry process and the norms. This really helps me to put my experience in my resume and helps me a lot for the future courses. Okay. Here's some car parks. And actually, we have a lot of car parks around the campus and in the campus. Well, we are walking to our next area. I will tell you about some of the facilities that we won't be going inside today. For anyone interested in study IT, especially in the areas of networking and cybersecurity, we have our Cisco labs. This is where the students are taught the content of Cisco certifications. There's a lot of specialized networking equipment like routers, switches, and security devices. And the power system lab is used by all students study the electrical and electronic engineering. This lab has all types of motors, transformers. This device are used in various industries, for example, like the energy industry, power companies, mining industry, oil industry. And I heard this power system lab's gonna have the $300,000 worth of equipment. The fortunately is I have many classes that I have to test in this lab. For example, like power electronics courses, we can build any circuits we want to test and perform the related power test in this lab. This can be verified in both directions with the results derived from the calculations. It's really useful. And there is also a mechatronics lab, where the students look at the suspension system, mobile robots, industrial control stations, and the data acquisition software. I'm excited to show you our next facilities, the UniSA flight deck. Inside are our two flight simulators. One is Boeing 737, and another is the best latest Airbus A320 flight simulators. This facility is used for our Bachelor of Aviation students who are studying the flight strain. And let's go inside and have that look, a chat to our aviation staff. Hello, Dylan. How are you?
Hi, Xiao. I'm good, thanks.
Could you tell us a little bit about yourself and these flight simulators?
My name is Dylan. I'm one of the lecturers on the aviation course. I also work full-time as an airline pilot. And this is our brand new suite of aviation simulators. Crew's just gone into our 737 sim for one of their training exercises, and this is our brand new installed last month Airbus A320 simulator. Should we go inside and take a look? So our students in the first 2 years do their flying training out at Parafield, just down the road from the Mawson Lakes campus here. And then the third year, they come in to do a course in large aircraft operations. They come into one of these two simulators, and it introduces them to flying a large jet aircraft, working as two pilots rather than just one, and simulating as if they're working at a real airline. So this new facility that we've got's really given us a lot of flexibility, a lot of different experiences for our students on the course.
Oh, thank you, Dylan. That's really interesting. I believe there no one can refuse to try that simulators.
Yeah, the students definitely enjoy this part of the course.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
As an international student, you can also try to find a part-time job since you are studying. For example, like me, I'm working at the University of Australia as a student ambassador. These jobs mean a lot because it provided a lot of opportunities to let me to participate in each of the student events or the university events. And I also need to contact the future or the new student to help them to solve each problem. For example, like where they want to live, where they are studying, and what the course degree it is, what the structure of the degree it is. That's really interesting. And I think maybe some of yours already spoke to me on the phone. Okay, let's go into the laboratories. Inside the library, we can see the campus central counter, and on this side, we have career service. Let's go chat to them. Hello, Sharon.
Hello, Shu. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you again. How are you today?
Yes, I'm fine, thank you. And you?
Yeah, good. Could you tell me how the career service can assist a student?
Absolutely. We can help students from the very beginning of their degree to help them support with planning and progress towards their career. We help with part-time work whilst they're studying and to also help them find internships or gaining experience. And obviously at the end of their degree to support them with career graduate roles. We particularly in this area support students with quick questions about their resume writing, about interview skills, and also about managing online applications. If you've got a more complex question, we can help you with a career guidance and arrange an appointment for you to gain further insights into strategies for your career direction.
Okay, that's excellent. But could you also tell us, at what stage in our studies should students start thinking about their career development?
Well, we strongly recommend that you come at the beginning of your degree, and particularly to use our career readiness program, where you'll be given some questions and be able to review your progress over the course of your studies. It's been really great to see you again.
Yeah, I'm really good to see you again also. And thank you very much, Sharon. Have a good day.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. When you become a student at UniSA, I highly recommend you to speak into the career service for advice, because the ways that you set your resume or prepare the interview, the questions, might be slightly different between your country and the Australia. So it's a really good idea to speak to the expert in this area. For example, I'm going to the career service and asking for the modify my resume. And after that, I received the two interviews invitations. That's really, really helpful to me. I have spent countless days in this library on countless group meetings. And the most interesting thing is the library always becomes very busy at the end of each semester. This is the main courtyard here at Mawson Lakes. It's a nice spot to come and relax when the sun is out. And there are something over this thing way that I want to show you. This sign shows how far away the other countries are from here, because then Hong Kong is closer to my countries. There's one more building I will be taking you on this tour. This place is where you can buy the food. There's a lot of options for your dietary requirements as well, like vegetarian meals. Mawson Lakes Campus is also a short walk away from the Mawson Lakes shopping area, where there's a large grocery store. On this side, you can use the kitchen facilities to heat up your food or store your items in the fridge. Come through to the student lounge now. I like the how events and clubs are always promoted on this wall, as there are always something to do. The reason why I want to live in the Mawson Lakes because there are too many supermarkets and restaurants around the campus. For example, like Woolworths, Aldi, and some Chinese restaurant, Korean restaurants. There are lots of restaurants which you can choose what you like. That's the end of the campus tour of Mawson Lakes. I hope you liked seeing all the facilities and wish you all the best with your future studies. Maybe one day you will be studying here at this campus too. Okay, goodbye, see ya.